My name is Robert Wilson, and I am a grumpy farmer in the Scottish Borders. But there's one thing, even on the wettest, most miserable days, that cheers me up, and that's nature. In a recent study by Leeds Beckett University, they thought nature prescriptions could be a really cheap way to helping people's mental health. And I can see why. But what if there was less nature, less habitats, bare-sided riverbanks, crops going right up to the side of rivers and the base of hedges, fields grazed bare so there were no nesting sites, funds labelled as for public good have been available to many farmers over the last few years to help restore habitats and help nature. Many of these habitats that were damaged after the war when the country was very hungry. We've had help to put in grass margins beside watercourses. Now these watercourses eventually run down to the beach about 30 miles away. Now we don't want anything from the likes of the cows or the fields that we put on like fertiliser to reach those beaches. We're encouraged to be a little bit more sensitive on some places in the farm to, you know, leave wildflowers and species rich grassland just that little bit longer so it's got a chance to bloom and set seed. On some areas of the farm where we take silage and hay, we're encouraged just to leave it that little bit longer so that, you know, birds have a chance to fledge. Now I don't want to sound like that grumpy farmer again, complaining about the weather or loss of financial assistance, but quite simply we can't justify these schemes ourselves. We do need assistance. We don't mind doing our bit and putting a hand in the pocket, and at the moment a lot of the management options don't cover the full cost of doing it properly. But for the benefit of the countryside and the benefit of everybody to enjoy the countryside, then we do need to make sure that there's funding available for agroecology or nature-friendly farming, as I like to call it.